term fool, both as known
chem
and as
fool,
is used many times by Solomon himself. And I told you that fool, it depends how it is translated in the Bible, because but when fool in the Hebrew is meant, it would refer to someone who is said used.
Meta l-kelma fool iblaħ tintuża fil-Bibija di tfisser bniedem
sedjuż. Sedjuż is someone who allowed himself to fall into kind of sweet talk of another. Provokatki, dziękuję ci, mówić się to prowadzali.
Il-kelma tedjuża hawnhekk qed tirreferi hemm meta aħna nħallu l-xaħat ikellimna b'waħ ħelu u jinnexxiel jkun.
When you read Proverbs like chapter 3 and 4, you'll find how the woman seduces a man. With the nice words, you know, flirting and so forth.
Seduce
a man. That's the word. That's the word seduce or fool.
Kelma fil-Grek li jibru barkellu dwar kif ma nizzin id-diskrivi il-fuq zibla.
Look at Solomon, he was so seduced by the things of this world.
Ħamma kalla hum ġi seduċu bl-affarijiet ta' din id-dinja.
He allowed circumstances to seduce him from remaining faithful.
Għadda ċertu ċirkostanzi jibtedu ċuħ, jikonin ċuħ, mill-li ma jibqax fi din lejn Alla.
Now, my position is this. My position, you could have your own position.
Jista jkonna l-pozizjoni tagħna, ma l-pozizjoni tija hija din.
Nobody is seduced.
Ħadd huwa seduċu.
But you can't give yourself to seduction. You can always say no. You can always do like Joseph and run away from any kind of sin. I'm not talking about sexual sin, any other temptation. And we can do this by learning about the grace of God. Because the grace of God, my favorite verse, teaches us.
Grazie a Talla,
Tallimna
nejdu
ne. All ungodliness.
Għalda kollu li mujġġej
worldly
pleasures.
These two things that make Talla fall are these two things that the grace of God will teach us to say no to them. Solomon did not practice what he knew.
Salamun ma kienx qed jipprattika dak li kien jaf.
And we can learn from his examples and from his mistakes.
U nistgħu nitgħallmu mill-esperjenza tiegħu.
And therefore, when the word of God comes to us,
meta kelma tagħha tiġi magħna, nisimgħuha,
you must allow it to fall on good ground. Irridu
nħalluha taqa' f'art tajba.
Because only when the word of God falls on good ground it can produce good fruit. If it falls on the road, that means it has not been crushed to the heart,
then
it will come and take it away. You would say, oh, Pastor, you spoke to my heart today, but I would say, oh, great, next week I see a change. A month further, it's the same thing. If the
sea
falls on shallow ground,
yes, zerriya taqa f'art li hija baxxa,
and we're happy and joyful of being born again,
u aħna ferħanin li aħna kristjani mwdi,
and the persecution comes,
imma mbagħad tiġi l-persekuzzjoni,
whether we're going to obey God or not. And I don't think persecution refers to ISIS murdering Christians, unless they
are
Muslims. But for any kind of pressure to disobey.